Alright, what's going on, guys? Since the Elden Ring DLC trailer dropped a little over a month ago, we've been going all in on the lore investigation, breaking down a lot of the themes and symbolism we can find in the trailer, and during that investigation, almost all of it has been leading us back to one place, that being Mount Gelmir and the Volcano Manor, a place devoted to the blasphemy of Rykard and the home of the Recusants, the bloody fingers who hunt their own kind. But we have a pretty good idea of what the DLC is going to be about, and as far as we know, it doesn't take place in the lands between, and a direct connection to Volcano Manor is unlikely. So what I want to do today is go through every symbol we can find that we currently know of overlapping between Volcano Manor and the DLC trailer, and discuss the meanings behind them in a hope to get a clearer picture of the trailer and what our story will be and the new lore that will be uncovered when we finally step foot there. So as we begin today, if you want to stay up to date on all things Elden Ring DLC and enjoy the lore and discussion, go ahead and hit that subscribe button, and now let's begin. When the DLC trailer first dropped, the most striking part of it was, of course, Messmer, the long-lost demigod erased from history and veiled away in the Land of Shadow. Now, we've talked about his character at length, the little we know about him, but what makes his design so striking and evocative to players that have paid attention are all the different symbols we see. He is characterized by the two-headed red snake that also happens to have wings attached to his body. He has red hair like Radagon and the eyes of those who have partaken of dragon communion. He has a red banner of sorts wrapped around him, is long, pale, and lanky, wields an interesting looking spear, as well as a uniquely colored fire. And what was able to be immediately noted is that many of these symbols are things considered blasphemous in the lands between. Now, we've made an entire video breaking down the symbolism on Messmer, and to avoid rehashing many of the same points, I'm only going to cover the ones in relation to Volcano Manor, the first of which are winged snakes. Statues of snakes with wings can be found all over Volcano Manor, and we don't see anything else quite like it throughout the entirety of the game, aside from the statues of dragons, although the comparison would be a bit of a reach. Snakes are commonly used as symbols of allegiance against the Erdtree. It's why the duelists were forced to wear the symbols of snakes while they were beaten and battered in the Colosseum, and the depraved perfumers who turned against the Erdtree wore their symbol of two red snakes. Now, although there was once upon a time a war between the dragons and Laendel, dragons themselves are not seen with the same contempt that snakes are. There's a very clear divide there when it comes to the symbolism. Now, in our video on Messmer, we theorized that this hatred for snakes stems back to a cardinal sin that he might have committed in burning the Erdtree, which would result in snakes being the symbol of curses against the Erdtree, and all record of Messmer being erased from history. To which Rykard, someone actively seeking out forms of blasphemy, became inspired by and adopted his symbolism. And there may be even more evidence for this when we look into the Church of Begley. One of the decorations in here are these long red drapes with golden trimmings and threads off the end that hang from the balconies. Interestingly, these drapes are identical to what Messmer is wearing as a covering. The only difference being that when we look at the collector's edition figure, his cloak slash drape that he's wearing has his sigil on the back. But there's even more evidence, supplemental at least, to suggest that the serpent was a form of blasphemy long ago. Now, in the video on Messmer, we talked about how the duelist and their symbolism of the snake predate Rykard, suggesting that something caused the serpent to be seen as an enemy to the Erdtree long before he came to be the Lord of Blasphemy. And something else that would suggest that is the Serpent Hunter Spear, which in the introduction of its item description says, weapon that serves as both greatsword and spear, thought to have been used to hunt an immortal great serpent in the distant past. It manifests a long blade of light when facing such a creature. So this description appears to suggest that Egle has been hunted before, prior to the communion with Rykard. Now, contrasting that with the description of the Serpent God's Curved Sword, which describes an ancient religion on Mount Gelmir where they worshipped the immortal serpent. And interestingly enough, this weapon grants the wielder HP upon defeating an enemy. But now let's look at another item that does that exact same thing, the Taker's Cameo Talisman. This talisman is dedicated to Rykard and depicts various symbols that describe his blasphemy with the serpent. We see the hands with the skeleton on the left, symbolizing the people killed and joined to the serpent, a kingly image of Rykard in the middle, depicting him as Lord of Volcano Manor, and then on the right we have two snakes, once again, biting at a very interesting symbol. Now, it looks to be just some form of stylized fleur-de-lis, a common symbol of royalty, and with the two snakes on the Taker's Cameo specifically, it could be representing the idea of devouring the gods. But when we look at symbols of the gods and royalty in Elden Ring, we don't find this one specifically, but we do find it in the DLC trailer. In this shot of the player fighting against Messmer, however, using the new dueling shield weapon, we can get a good look at it in a few very short frames, such as this shot right here, and we can zoom in very closely on the shield itself, where we'll notice that it is the exact same symbol that's on the Taker's cameo. But what is this symbol? Well, as it stands right now, I think we lack the context to say anything for certain, but we can frame this among other connections in Volcano Manor. Popping back to the Church of Egle, we have this shrine at the back of the room. It's very rugged in appearance, with winding columns like a snake, the same kind of which appear in the audience chamber, which has a design that is entirely different than pretty much everything else in the manor, leading many to believe that this room and the altar in the Church of Egle are much older, possibly places of worship by that ancient serpent cult. Which makes it interesting that we see this same Solomonic motif all throughout the DLC trailer, with their construction constantly employing these winding columns. Now, it would be a significant leap in judgment to say that the columns in the DLC are evidence of the serpent cult in the Land of Shadow, but I think what we can glean from this is a look into the other cultures that the Golden Order has overwritten, which is shaping up to be a major theme of the DLC, which was the point we were driving home in the last lore video about House Murray, which gives us a good look into the culture and way royalty works without the influence of Queen Merica and the Golden Order, which does actually connect to Volcano Manor, considering that Inquisitor Giza, who invades the player on the second story, is a member of House Murray, as we can tell by him wearing the Murray robe and the bandages signifying the curse of the Murray males, which then raises questions about Tanith, who wears a robe almost identical to the Murray robe and is said to be a dancer from a foreign land. And why is she guarded by a Crucible Knight of all things? I mean, we see that the Crucible is a big theme in the DLC trailer, as we've mentioned many times in past lore videos on it. It's a pretty far-fetched idea, but could it be that the Murray family was originally from the Land of Shadow, but perhaps allowed to come to the Lands Between due to their handling of the capital's dirty work? We do also see similar mask motifs on two of the NPCs at the beginning. But the final thing I want to touch on today is the actual boss fight in the Church of Egle. Here the player is faced with a Godskin noble. Now the Godskins themselves deserve a second look after the DLC trailer, on a surface level, due to how similar they look to Messmer, at least the Apostle, in sharing that long, pale, and lanky frame, but they also wear very similar bracers, and have a decently striking facial resemblance. But much like Messmer as well, the Godskins are part snake, with the Godskin noble having a snake's tail, and the Godskin Apostle having a stretchy body, becoming long as a snake. There's definitely something going on here between the Godskins and Messmer, and although I'm not entirely sure what it is at the moment, I do believe it's worth keeping an eye on and at the back of your mind. And as to why the Godskin noble is the boss of the Church of Egle, that may very well have something to do with it, so I'm curious to hear what you guys think about that. So as you can hopefully clearly see, there's a lot going on here between Volcano Manor and symbolism we see in the DLC trailer. And although we're not going to have the answers until June, right now we have a golden opportunity to investigate these similarities and try to come up with an intriguing explanation. Which is why I didn't want to present any conclusions in this video, mainly just things I found fascinating, and I want to hear what you guys think so we can all bounce off ideas. But y'all let me know, are we chasing ghosts here, or is there something clearly going on? Anyways though guys, that's going to pretty much do it for the video today. I hope you enjoyed. If you did, be sure to leave a like on it and subscribe if you're new around here. But with all that, I will catch you in the next one.